Would you all please sit down? 4 centuries ago, John Napier of Merkeston, from whom this university proudly takes its name, invented logarithms. This is one of the greatest contributions to the advancement of knowledge. It was a great step. It underpinned Kepler's work on the orbit of the planets and Newton's theory of gravity. Well, today you, Edinburgh Napier's newest graduates, take your own next step. History records the support and encouragement to work and study that John Napier received through his faith, from his family and friends, and from those who read his work. We share today's joy with those who have helped us reach this step. And so I invite you to begin this ceremony today with a moment's reflection to give thanks for the support we've received and the strength we've been given by others. Good, well, I now declare our graduation ceremony open, and I invite the Principal and Vice-Chancellor, Professor Andrea Nolan, to deliver her address.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Usher Hall and our graduation ceremony, which is a very special event for the university. Indeed, it really, graduation ceremonies are the highlight of our year. You can imagine that as a university, we've held very many graduations, but for us, each of them is unique. They're unique because they represent a milestone in the journey of the university as we set a new cohort of graduates out into the world. But they're also unique for each of you as they represent a significant milestone in your careers. And I want to offer you my warmest congratulations. We are here today in this communal celebration because of you, to acknowledge your achievements and your success. And because there's such excitement and emotion around the day coming at you from every direction, you could very easily pass on from this moment without fully appreciating and feeling the weight of your achievement. I know that it has taken hard work, commitment, and sacrifices to complete your course of study. And we all here salute your successful negotiation of this journey. But your journey, I also realize, will not have been a solo effort. Today, family, friends, and university colleagues sit together, bridging generations and cultures. All around me and throughout the hall are the staff of the university who, like me, take great pride in your achievements. They are passionate about learning, about making a difference, about education. So my congratulations and thanks goes to them. I also want to recognize and congratulate your family, your supporters, and your friends, because it is their day too. And I speak from personal experience because my son graduated this summer, and when I say it from the heart. It was a truly memorable and a special occasion, one to be treasured. So, graduates, remember your families and friends and the staff today. Perhaps introduce them to each other, share with the group some of your university experiences, because today we're all part of one community. During this day, I hope you will also have a moment to reflect on what it has taken you to get where you are, but perhaps more significantly, where it might lead you in the future. It was John Ruskin, prominent Victorian social thinker and philanthropist, who said, "The highest reward for a man's toil is not what he gets for it, but what he can become by it." So today is also, I believe, a celebration of your potential, of what you can become, and of the many ways I know you will contribute to the social, cultural, and an economic development of the communities you will go on to live and work in. As our new ambassadors, you step out of this hall into a complex environment, one with very many challenges, but also rich with opportunity. On the back of a record turnout of 84% in the Scottish independence referendum, you're entering an environment where engagement and debate about the future of Scotland is at an all-time high. However you voted, That engagement with the political process is something of which all of us who live in this country should be proud. It speaks of a debate enriched by mass participation and active citizenship. And active citizenship through engagement with your many communities, be they local, national, or international in their reach, is required of us all collectively as we seek to address societal challenges. Challenges such as climate change, poverty, gender inequality, an aging society, while at the same time dealing with transformations and disruptions in our lives being brought about by communications technology. I am confident that the learning and development you experienced in Edinburgh Napier will have prepared you well for this environment. For it was our purposeful intention throughout your time with us in Edinburgh Napier to support you, not just in acquiring knowledge, but in developing as creative, confident, adaptable individuals, fit to thrive in our highly connected, rapidly changing world. In the words of the French novelist Marcel Proust, the voyage of discovery is not in seeking new landscapes, but in having new eyes. And I hope that you have the confidence throughout your careers to have new eyes, to question received wisdoms and orthodoxies, to challenge tradition, and to make a difference. As a university, those characteristics are in our DNA. We started life as a small technical college some 50 years ago, producing graduates that went on to contribute to building a new economy. Today, we have grown to become one of the largest universities in Scotland, with a very strong reputation for the employability of our graduates and the relevance and impact of our research. We take pride in that recognition and take care to provide our students with learning that combines academic challenge with workplace relevance, while also giving students a range of extracurricular opportunities to develop their skills and their networks. Universities alongside education have another role, and that is to conduct research so that we can advance knowledge in ways that make a difference. So today, staff from the business school are working, for example, with academics in Qatar to study how interest in the Soccer World Cup can be used to influence social change and help green and active living. Others are working with lawyers and healthcare professionals to improve the lives of those who suffer from mental health and incapacity issues. And this research is important to us. Alongside education, it is fundamental to the mission of universities. And so our scientists and engineers, working with our health and social care providers and our colleagues in the arts and humanities, support an ecosystem of inquiry and discovery. And we do three things. First of all, we provide answers to challenging questions through our discovery process. Secondly, and just as importantly, we provide questions. Doubt is a great motivator of advancement of knowledge. And last, but by no means least, we provide meaning to our world as our colleagues in the social sciences and the humanities interpret how we can use advancing technologies and their impacts on societies. So the research that we do truly has an impact on people's lives. I know I speak for all the staff here today when I say how proud I am to have you as Edinburgh Napier graduates. I hope you have enjoyed your experience here and that you feel a strong attachment to the university and to the city, and that the friendships you have made during your time with us are deep and enduring. Please retain your ties with us by telling us about your progress. Take pride in our achievements, speak of your time with us, and help shape our future by engaging with us as valued alumni. And a final comment. when I was looking for a card for my son's graduation earlier this summer, I noted one that said, "May each day be worthy of a story." And so this is my personal wish for you, that day by day you write your own story with passion, confidence, and distinction, and that your career is not only fulfilling and rewarding, but filled with excitement and adventure. I hope this day will remain special in your memories for a very long time. Thank you. I would now like to introduce Professor George Stonehouse, who will deliver the laureation for the conferment of the Honorary Doctorate of the University to Mr. Ian Craig.
Chancellor, it is my privilege to present Mr. Ian Craig for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University. Ian Craig is the CEO of both Lothian Buses and Transport Edinburgh. He hails from Kintyre in the west of Scotland, and transport is in his blood. His family business, West Coast Motors, is run by Ian's brother, Colin, and is one of the oldest and largest independent bus and coach companies in Scotland. Ian's own passion for public transport began when he was 3 years old. His father would allow him to sit inside the cab of his bus and take him on the morning school run. I wonder how Ian would now react if his Lothian bus drivers were to follow his father's example. The bus itself was an old Albion that he and his father affectionately called Alfie. It was not so much the noise, smell, or motion that captivated Ian. Rather, it was the fact that his father, with Alfie's help of course, could move around 60 kids from home to school safely and efficiently. Ian has said that when growing up, his dad was his hero, and he still is. At the age of 18, Ian acquired his own PCV license, which meant that for the first time, he could legally sit in the cab of a bus and actually drive it. It also meant that he was driving his schoolmates around in the bus. This, as you can imagine, made him very popular, very quickly, with the older girls. So buses have always played an important role in Ian's life, and he even met his future wife, Claire, while driving the long-distance coach service between Campbelltown and Glasgow. Claire was working in the chip shop at Inverary during the holidays and would commute from her home in Loch Gair. As Ian noted, between my half-mast nylon trousers and her gingham apron that always stunk of the fryer she had just left behind, we weren't the most attractive or glamorous couple. Definitely not Posh and Becks. He didn't know for a long time that she was in fact studying to be a commercial interior designer, and she didn't realize that Ian's family owned the coaches that she traveled on, thinking that he was just a regular driver. 5 years after that first meeting, they were married, and they now have a 12-year-old daughter and 10-year-old twin boys. Ian left the family business in 1996 to join Scottish City Link coaches in Glasgow before moving to Paisley-based Arriva in 1999. A short journey south of the border to Arriva, Yorkshire, where he was commercial director, was followed by, in 2003, a return to Scotland to assume full managerial responsibility for Arriva West Scotland. Since 2006, Ian has held the position of Managing Director of Lothian Buses Limited, the principal provider of transport in Edinburgh and the near Lothians. As you can tell, Ian has come a long way since he graduated from Napier College with an HND in accounting. He regrets the fact that he didn't stay on to do a BA in accountancy or business studies, as he found his year in Edinburgh among the most formative in his life. Nevertheless, Ian says that his experience at Napier and the qualification that he gained have acted as the foundations for his successful career. Although there have been low points during Ian's life, when serious accidents have occurred and when commercial decisions have ended with people losing their jobs, these have been outweighed by the high points. He has enjoyed creating new routes and observing people use the service provided. He's also gained huge satisfaction from helping to sustain the family business through a difficult period when much bigger competitors threatened it. Equally satisfying has been working his way through the corporate ranks of larger companies in his own right, and not just because his family background in transport. At Lothian Buses, being appointed as a company director, then managing director, and more recently as chief executive, were all significant landmarks, crowned by delivering Edinburgh trams into passenger service on the 31st of May 2014, a day Ian won't quickly forget. Ian is strongly committed to developing sustainable transport systems. In recognition of his achievements, he was winner of the Outstanding Contribution to Public Transport at the Scottish Transport Awards in 2012, and Edinburgh and Lothian Buses were named as the best green large company in Scotland in the same year. Under his leadership, the company was shortlisted for Public Transport Operator of the Year in 2013 at the Scottish Transport Awards. And also in 2012, the company was once again shortlisted as the Green Business of the Year and the Scottish Business Awards. Chancellor, in recognition of his major contribution to business and transport, I invite you to confer on Ian Craig the honorary degree of Doctor of the University.
Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, members of the University Court, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen. 25 years ago, almost to the day, I last attended the Usher Hall, and I haven't been back since. The purpose that day was to graduate from what was referred to then as Napier Polytechnic of Edinburgh with a higher national diploma in accountancy. For me, the academic journey to that graduation day was most certainly not an easy one. And I remember it was with some relief that I felt I had made it. Now, when I say made it, I mean successfully concluded a period of rather inglorious study. However, I felt that the time was right for me to launch myself into the world of work and commerce. I didn't know it then, but what I had learned in these two formative years at Edinburgh Napier would be the basis of my professional understanding and knowledge that would sustain me for the next 25. It really is an honor, an incredible thrill, and huge pleasure to be awarded this doctorate today by a university that will always have a special significance to me. For those of you graduating, I guarantee that this is a day that you will not forget. My advice would be savor your moment, be proud of your achievements, and make sure you take the opportunity to reflect with your friends and family on times past and the exciting opportunities that now lie ahead. I'll be doing the same with my family. I'm sure the starting point, however, of our conversation, especially with my sister, who actually had to study for her PhD, will be along the lines of, you, a bus driver from Campbelltown, how on earth did that happen? As Professor Stonehouse has already alluded, my journey into public transport started at a very young age. You might even say that, like the rest of my immediate family, we have this vocation embedded in our DNA. From accompanying Dad driving Alfie as a three-year-old on the school run around our hometown, to today being Chief Executive of Transport for Edinburgh, it's a personal journey that simply would not have happened without a set of values and beliefs and behaviours that you get from devoted, supportive, and most of all, loving parents. Whatever I am today, I owe to them. Now, unfortunately, they can't be here. However, I hope, I sincerely hope that for just one day, I've made them proud. Now, of course, there is no Punch without Judy. There is no Ken without Barbie. And for the last 20 years, there is no Ian without Claire. Clara, you are and you continue to be my soulmate, my best friend, and my inspiration. To those of you graduating today who are about to embark on your own professional journey, if I may, I have three short pieces of advice. Firstly, pay your dues with hard work. There is no fast track to success, and you will only get out what you put in. So get ready, because the blood, sweat, and tears, yes, tears, start right now. Secondly, regardless of what you do, work with the best people that you possibly can. It doesn't matter if you don't like an individual, their style, or even their methods. If they can lead a team, if they're an effective communicator, if they can create strategy that translates into actions and then results, my advice would be suck up that experience and learn all that you possibly can. And finally, remember, you are the future. No one is going to tell you what you can't do, what you can't have, or what you can't achieve. To exceed your goals, and I mean really go far, technical knowledge and competence needs to be blended with personal qualities and behaviors that most people don't have when they start out. I'm talking about patience, understanding, humility, empathy, humor, and grace. The quicker you develop this aspect of your professional life, I guarantee the quicker success will follow. Fellow graduates, good luck and congratulations. I wish you all every success for your future and hope you will be as blessed and fortunate as I have been. Thank you.
Earlier this year, we launched a competition to mark Edinburgh Napier University's 50th anniversary celebrations. It was open to undergraduate and postgraduate students registered on our music programs. And the remit was to compose a short celebratory piece of music to be performed during each of our 2014 graduation ceremonies. The winner was PhD student Fraser Burke, and it's my pleasure now to introduce to you the winning work entitled Peris Ma Guch, which translated from the Gaelic back to English means good luck, safe trip.
students from the business school for the following awards. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a program of work entitled Developing an Instrument to Measure Readiness for Change in the German Public Sector, Comparative Study Between Civil Servants and Non-Civil Servants of the Deutsche Bahn AG, Britta Ulrich. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a program of work entitled UK Foreign Direct Investment in Ghana, Determinants and Implications, Collins Osei. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a program of work entitled The Impact of German Guarantee Banks on the Access to Finance for SMEs, Anke Valentin. Chancellor, I now call upon the Head of School of Accounting, Financial Services and Law to present the students from the Business School for their awards.
Chancellor, I am pleased to present students from the Business School for the following awards. For the award of Master of Science, Accounting and Finance, winner of the University Medal, winner of the Douglas Sivright Award, Raphael Bass. Dean Nodzak. Martin Steffens. Winner of the University Medal, Ilinka Vlad. Rhoda Mehdi Agbeshi. Mark Altenberg. Zoya Atanasova. Anima Hota. Nicholas Kesley. Yaki Liu. Aurelia Obel Okom. Dana Serifidu. Lee Yang. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Accounting with Corporate Finance, Esther Nadelia Longino. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Accounting with Corporate Finance, Laura Jane King. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Accounting with Human Resource Management, Katerina Dominika Loznikov. For the award of Master of Science, Banking and Financial Regulation, Jean Xu. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Financial Services, Gary Nolan. Bosco Kyoko Mutoka. Dong Zhao. For the award of Master of Science, International Banking and Finance, winner of the University Medal, Timo Fittig. Winner of the University Medal, Philip Vessel. Nirina Adriamaroson. René Wilhelm Kaus. Wan Tong Teng. Ermela Thanasi. Jizi Tong. for the award of Master of Laws, International Commercial Law, Andamara and Andia Pradipta. Manisha Nelamkuzio. For the award of Master of Science, International Finance, Yiping Bao. Jing Kai. Guan Hong Chen. Jian Chen. Xiaojin Chen. Tianjian Chen. Zhaozheng Chen. Jin Cheng. Zhao Zhuang Ding. Li Fan. Hui Fang. Winner of the University Medal, Fai Gao. Jing Ji. Danyang Geng. Yu Gu. Yafeng Han. Qi Jia. Fulin Jiang. Yazi Zhu. Wen Leng. Bai Li. Jialu Li. King Peng Li. Huan Meng. Zhang Yupeng. Yuhi Qian. Ren Biao Shi. Yidan Tang. Long Hao Tang. Guozhen Wang. Xuzhun Zhao. Ji Yang. Kai Yang. Shaoshen Yang. Yifan Yu. Qi Zhang. Zhou Bai Zhang. Ji Kun Zhang. Junzi Zhao. Shang Yu Zhao. Run Zuo. For the award of Master of Business Administration, Morrison Ayedada. Brian William Butler. Albert Duthie. Daniel L. Scaff. Alistair Ian Ford Hamilton. Tan Hui Yun. Leslie Joan McNeil. Akbat Mir. Jing Xuan Zi. Michael Sharp. Li Xiu Teng. Vine Yi Yu. For the award of Master of Business Administration Executive, winner of the University Medal, winner of the MBA Project Prize, Sally Connolly. Winner of the Neil McPherson Memorial Prize, Julie Dixon. Mary Johnson Horsburgh. John Jason Robertson. For the award of Postgraduate Diploma, Business Administration, Franklin Amponsa Tai. For the award of Master of Science, Business Management, winner of the University Medal, Stefan Peter Langenegger. Mikhail Andre Garcia Calado. Jolanta Jukuti. Avitra Fiona Lutan. Darren Mertens. Shireen Rashid. Magnus Vindin. Tao Jing. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Business Management, Anna Maria Ozog. Abdul Munim Shoaib. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Business Management, Amy Beatson. Denise Hughes. Ian Key. Julie Russell. Annie Marit Natalia Sternquist. Amy Lee Collister. Gareth Wellesby. For the award of Master of Science, Business Management, Entrepreneurship, winner of the University Medal, David Reed. Mikkel Adam Duschmal. Henrik Flutve. Felix Ternissen. Sebastian Hub van Zana. For the award of Master of Science, Business Management, Human Resource Management, Graham Walker. For the award of Master of Science, Business Management, Marketing, winner of the University Medal, Niels Torben Honerkamp. Anika Dorothy Lishi. For the award of Master of Science, Business Management, Sales, Athanasios Agathos. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Business Management with Accounting, Janneke Ramstad Sandvik. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Business Management with Tourism, Maike Stukley. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Business Practice, Sandwich, Daniel Aaron Cohen. Keith James Johnson. Kimberly Ritchie. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Business Studies Sandwich, Rebecca Rose Milne. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Business Studies with Human Resource Management Sandwich, Ross Aldred. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Business Studies with Marketing Sandwich, Nicola Jean Cowison. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Economics with Management, Dominic William Lynch. For the award of Master of Science, Human Resource Management, winner of the CIPD Branch Awards Prize, Peter Patrick Heath. Winner of the University Medal, Melissa Kennedy. Stephen Amoa. Olufemi Asimolovo. Lucy Barrowman. Andrew Burgess. Demeltsa Callow. Lee Crossan. Fiona Donaldson. Kimberly Dunn. Monica Jeek. Rachel Edwards. Neil Ferguson. Tamsin G. Cara Gilroy. Jacqueline Hunter. Jean Keir. Fiona Kimber. Winner of the University Medal, Malaika Isolde Langer. Stephanie Long. Alison Malcolm. Kim Miko. Kate Patterson. Winner of the CIPD Branch Awards Prize, Lucy Allison Redmayne. Rachel Robertson. Gail Carolyn Sneddon. Gillian Steele. Callum Tierney. Callum Andrew Watson. Katrina Watson. James White. Jan Ruth Williamson. For the award of Master of Science, International Business Management, winner of the University Medal, Berent Leistemoker. Tom Spears. Jan Griesbaum. Mavis Gutu. Pierre Antoine Hardouin. Jana Kriskova. Angelica Morrow. Daswinth Rajendran. Ravi Jot Singh. Sharon Nambiar Surishan. Gerald Tambula. Henriette Weber. Campbell Young. Cheng Shunzi Zhu. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, International Business Studies Sandwich, Claire Donnellan. For the award of Master of Science, International Human Resource Management, Roberta Butafuoco. Anya Catherine Hartner. Zora Iftikhar. Alicia Kuczynska. Eva Muriale. Anne Cecile Helene Reglier. Manuela Ukura. Yan Tung Wu. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Festival and Event Management, Casey McAdam. Charlotte McMaster. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Festival and Event and Marketing Management, Candice Feynman. Louise Kelly. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, German with Tourism Management, Mark John Elliott. For the award of Master of Science, Heritage and Cultural Tourism Management, Anne Rurig. Panagiota Irini Barca. Fergus Neil Salveson Halliday. Ailey Moira Hamilton. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Hospitality Management, Hannah Stephanie Meredith. Priyanka Deswal. Sanjeev Rajiv Kumar. For the award of Master of Science, Hospitality and Tourism Management, Nazerka Baisholan. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Hospitality with Human Resource Management, Claire McEwen. For the award of Master of Science, Intercultural Business Communication, winner of the University Medal, Rachel Cameron. Greta Farali. Tina Hoffman. Ilse Karklina. Alina Eve Strothoff. Alicia Francisca Utz. Joanna Westhauser. For the award of Master of Science Intercultural Business Communication with TESOL, Mark Hutchinson. Winner of the University Medal, Enrico Marconcini. Nadine Akta. Dij Bell. Washian Liu. Caitlin Sarah Elliott. Rachel Elizabeth Edington. Elena Fertonani. Amanda Hamilton. Elaine Horan. Lillian Nandi McLeod. Iofi White. Fenporn Vutitantison. for the award of Master of Science, International Marketing, IPAG, Francesca Boom. Winner of the University Medal, Julia Deathlifts. Kristen Dranger. Edric Dandel Spence. Nina Trost Nielsen. Amelie DeFerrode. Funda Khan Lee. Ellen Oyen. Gabby Rosenkrantz. Jevgenia Smektala. Cheng Qian Ying. For the award of Master of Science, International Marketing with Tourism and Events, IPAG, Ruth Burton. Alistair James Cummings. Claire Simone Den Hertog. Winner of the University Medal, Anna Natasha Hantke. Natalia Sara Lasota. Heidi Tuliki Avanainen. Nuria Castellanos Lausas. Silvia Escudero Valero. Sarah Iverson. Alex Lachiver. For the award of Master of Science, International Tourism Management, winner of the University Medal, Kim Jana Remmers. Michaela Svobodova. Marta Alicia Satkowski. For the award of Master of Science Marketing, winner of the University Medal, Hannah Russell. Aza Omer Ahmed Mohammed. Jan Nicholas Buchtalek. Yi Lam Fung. Tiffany Matza. George Neep. Alexandra O'Connor. Lauren Ann Sibbald. Sarah Catherine Stenhouse. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Marketing Management, Catherine Bratton. Fiona Mearns Lamont. Christiana Strömsnes Norstadt. Julia Galligani. Melanie Skinner. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Marketing Management with Entrepreneurship, Christopher Wilson. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Marketing with Digital Media, Caroline Helene Fallon Felix. For the award of Master of Science, Marketing with Festival and Event Management, Constanze Bilfinger-Dengler. Natalie Dewar. Marie Clemens Hache. Winner of the University Medal, Nadine Hipf. Olua fun melayo Rita Oke. Lindsay Sarah Rose. For the award of Master of Science, Marketing with Sales Management, winner of the University Medal, Natalie Witzman. For the award of Master of Science, Tourism and Hospitality Management, winner of the University Medal, Maria Jawa de Souza Vieira. Cara Kristen Didio. Vlad Georgi Dubovan. Danielle Hintong Jeffrey. Georgia Canavu. Moon Chan Kim. Andreas Kakonis. Sukul Kundan. Claire Emily McLaughlin. Yukari Mitsuguchi. Christos Vlachos. Agia Zavaguli. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Tourism Management with Entrepreneurship, Virag Solimos Shabo. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Tourism Management with Entrepreneurship, Eva Svatzorova Sancheva. For the award of Master of Science, Tourism Marketing, winner of the University Medal, Katarina Wiskowska. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Business and Enterprise, Rebecca Abink. Carol Rose Armstrong. Carolyn Beatty. Shauna Bonner Ford. Siobhan Bramley. Kevin Busby. Alexandra Catling. Timothy John Davis. Donella Duff. Stephen James Ford. Andrew Robert Gartshore. Arlene Glynn. Christopher John Grunwell. Karen Hanna. Mark Hooker. Mark Eric Horan. Mark Kane. Christine Laverock. Angela McPhee. Winner of the University Medal, Gary Manatini. Callum McDermott. Matthew Conan McGee. Craig Metcalf. Winner of the University Medal, Susan Reynolds. James Smith. Jane Lucy Sutton. Andrew Talbot. Winner of the University Medal, Beverly Thorogood. Paul Tovorniki. Anne Upshon. Charles Craig Veach. Gillian Huano. Jenny Lee Evans. Paul Taylor. Tracy Whitfield. For the award of Master of Science, Entrepreneurial Leadership, David Allen Brewster. Jamie Andrew Craig. Ashton Evans. Gary Andrew Foy. Winner of the University Medal, Matthew Hughes. Patrick John McDonough. Robert James Stewart. For the award of Graduate Certificate, Management Practice, Glenn Colley. For the award of Master of Science, Combined Studies, Management and Diversity, Mohammed Hamid. For the award of Master of Science, Management, winner of the University Medal, Anna Elisa Arnold. Rosalie Yana Olivia Vivian Dorn. Winner of the University Medal, Achim Kiesler. Julia Pfitzer. Tony Vielkommen. Marion Sophie Adam. Malta Berling. Deborah Callister. Tobias Deisler. Clemens Maximilian Valentin Gar. Bastian Gereka. Nico Edler. Claudia Lerka. Alicia McDonald. Jessica Richter. Sarah Scheitler. Marie-Louise Siebenwerth. Yijin Wang. Anne Weigelt. Jian Zhao. Mylin Zheng. For the award of Master of Science, Management with Finance, Mark Kvat. Michael Schmidt. Daniel Mergel. For the award of Master of Science, Management with Marketing, Saskia Silkins. Natalia Semke. Catherine Stamm. Catherine Tabor. For the award of Master of Science, Management with Strategy, Rotsita Oleg Kirilova. Monica Maria Fallon. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of students from the Business School.
Would the graduands all please stand? By the powers vested in me by the University Court and the Academic Board of Edinburgh Napier University, I confer the awards to which you have been presented today. And for those eligible for an award but unable to attend today's ceremony, I'm pleased to confer the awards in absentia. Many congratulations to you all, and please be seated.
Thank you, Chancellor. It is a true honour and privilege to be speaking as your NSA student president on this monumental celebration marking the end of your student years here at Edinburgh Napier, which I hope have been the most memorable of your life so far. Faculty, parents, partners, relatives, friends, undergraduates and postgraduates, welcome, and of course, a huge welcome to the class of 2014. First of all, I'd like to congratulate you on putting in all the hard work that's got you here in this huge occasion in your lives. I think we should take a moment to thank all of those who assisted in making the time Napier has been of highs and lows from your first Freshers' Week to the relief of handing in your finished dissertation. We must thank the supportive friends that you have made at Napier, coursemates, flatmates from halls, and others along the road who dragged us out on those random weeknights with a 9 a.m. hand-in the following morning. Also, those who helped us through the caffeine-fueled all-nighters in the computing centre, staring at screens, struggling to make out what the symbols on the screen meant anymore. Some of the friends we have made at Napier will now be lifelong friends and have helped make you the graduate you are today, so a huge thank you must be said to them. Secondly, gratitude must be shown to the staff at the university, lecturers, librarians, catering and so on, all the people that supported your education, from passing on knowledge from issues on the course to finding a book in the library to giving you a healthy full Scottish breakfast in the morning. All appreciated. Also, a massive thank you must be given to our families and guardians for the support we've been given, be it financial, advice on how to work a washing machine, or supplying us with an actual meal when we needed them most. And last but not least, we must thank one of the biggest factors in helping us graduate, the internet. It is a genuine honour for me to be president of the Students' Association here for Napier today. I couldn't think of a group of students I'd rather represent than you all out there. With students from different backgrounds, cultures and aspirations that build up the core of the university, giving students the opportunity to learn from one another's cultures, Edinburgh Napier has an experience that not every other university can offer. Every one of you sitting here today should be immensely proud of yourselves, parents and guardians for raising such brainiacs, faculties for supplying the students with the knowledge to graduate, and of course, you the graduates who have worked tirelessly for the past few years. I know your hands are probably sick of clapping by now, but I'd like to ask everyone from the front to the back to please give yourself another massive round of applause. It is a great loss to Napier today, losing another group of fantastic students, and I hope you'll look back fondly on your years here at Edinburgh Napier. It is now down to you to go out and use the knowledge you've gained here to transform the world and be all you can be. I wanted to leave you off a few life-changing inspirational quotes. So I googled inspirational quotes and this is what I came back with. Your time is limited, don't waste it living someone else's life. Steve Jobs. The best revenge is massive success. Frank Sinatra. A person who never made a mistake, never tried anything new. Albert Einstein. And lastly, a true role model of our generation. Mickey Mouse. Live every moment as not to regret what you're about to do. So I guess my main points are don't live your life the way someone else wants you to live it. Live it the way you want to live it. And if you do receive a setback, get back up and strive for success in your next challenge. Finally, use your innovation to break the mold and don't be afraid to take a chance on a new idea. On a sincere note, I want to say a massive congratulations to every one of you sitting here today, and I wish you the very, very best of your future. Go and celebrate tonight. You have all earned it. Thank you, and all the best.
I am so privileged, I really am, to be Chancellor of Edinburgh Napier University, which I've been for the last 7 or 8 years, and they've been 7 or 8 years of really huge happiness for me, because to be Chancellor of such an aspirational, such a courageous, and such a clear-thinking, and such a thoroughly worthwhile place as this university is, great privilege. And one of the greatest privileges for me personally is these graduation ceremonies, because I'm able to meet you. I know it's only for a fleeting second when you come up onto the stage, but I do try to look into the eyes of every one of you, to hold your hand for a moment and look into your eyes and to hold eye contact with you and to shake your hand. And those gestures of eye contact and shaking your hand are to express how proud I am as your Chancellor of you. It's a huge achievement for you, and for me it's a matter of great, great pride. At that moment, when I'm looking into your eyes and shaking your hand, I'm representing the university, and you are representing yourselves and your own unique lives and what you're going to do with those unique lives as you move forward into the future. So I want you to have just a couple of thoughts, and this is the first thing I want you to have in mind. You know, how many of us in this lovely hall, you know, whatever it is, 1,000, must be 1,500, whatever it is here, the point is each and every one of us, me, you know, you, all of us, are unique human beings. And when we die, nothing can replicate us. We are unique. There's nobody like us anywhere, and there never will be. So what I want you to do is to take your uniqueness and to take your own personalities and your own lives and take the world on. Carpe diem. Take the world on. Be brave about it. Seize the day. Seize your lives by the scruff of the neck. Not the world, yourselves, what you can do, and do the very best you can. Whatever you can do, or dream that you can do with your lives, do it. Be bold. Be brave. Do it. And this is an old man of 75 talking to you. And my life is nearly over, and yours isn't. And I want you, read my lips, to use your lives. And I want you to bear in mind this too. As you use your lives, and you're so unique, use your lives, never let yourselves get trapped. Never let yourselves get trapped, particularly within the confines of other people's thinking, because other people's thinking is just as likely to be flawed as it is to be true. And why shouldn't your thinking be just as good as theirs? Have confidence in your own thinking. Be your own people. Follow your own hearts, follow your own intuition of what is right for you as you move forward into life. Live in your skin and not someone else's. So important that it really is, to live your lives within your own skins, within your own personalities. And do all that you can to express your own personalities, your own skills, the way you dress life. And try to develop all the time. As a human being, every year you should have developed more. And in that development, incidentally, never, ever, ever be afraid of defeats. Defeats are not failure. You know, the only thing that's failure is when you give up. Defeats is just part of life. And I tell you this, the most beautiful people I've ever known in my life are those who have known defeat. Beautiful people have known defeat, known suffering, known struggle, known personal failure, known personal disaster, known personal triumph, known loss, personal loss, and found their way through. And these beautiful people, and so they are beautiful, have an appreciation, a sensitivity, an understanding of what makes them whole, of what human lives are. It makes them real. Beautiful people don't just happen. Believe in good things, the good things in life, and never get bogged down with things that are wrong. You know, what are the good things about it? Love is good. Real people, beautiful human beings. Never lose a sense of wonder about how fantastic this place is. And I really do hope we've done one thing for you here, and it's this. I hope we've given you confidence, and if any of you didn't have confidence when you arrived, I really hope we've helped you to develop it, because confidence comes through a sense of understanding yourself and accepting yourself and understanding what your own skin is, understanding your own abilities, and understanding your own qualities and driving yourselves forward from there. And something that's really important to me, and actually it's why I'm here as Chancellor of this university, is that this is a university, and I think this is so important, this is a university that recognises that talent, quality, courage, all those things lie in all social classes, in all parts of the country, in all parts of the countries of the world, because this is not, and this is the heart of my point, this is not a university of or for privileged people, God forbid. It's not that, we all know that. What it is, and it's a wonderful thing, it's a university for aspirational people, motivated, driving, aspirational people, for real people. People who inspire, people who have courage, people who have guts, people who have focus in their lives. You are now individually the ambassadors of Edinburgh Napier in the world, and we're very proud of you for that. And so wherever your homes are, wherever you've come from, wherever you've been, wherever you're going now, those of you may be returning now to work in your homelands, wherever that may be, you know, China, Hong Kong, Singapore, India, Pakistan, Nigeria, wherever it may be, we say goodbye to you with a very particular sense of comradeship and loyalty and affection. Well, just carry this away with you, please, and then I'll close. Carry away that thought that each and every one of all of us, you, me, all of us here today, is unique and unbelievably important. And please, read my lips, please use your lives. Don't waste a moment of them. Use your lives. Become rich, but richness, believe you me, is not the possession of money, period. It's not that. Richness is living a life of honesty, living within your own skin, a life absorbed in using and enriching what you've got within your unique personalities, what you've been given. As the wonderful David Hockney, the artist, said the other day of other artists, all artists are rich, you know. They're doing what they want in life. They're rich. Which leaves me just this to share with you and wish for you that lovely Apache blessing which I first came across decades and decades ago, and I never lose in my mind that this is the Apache blessing, and I give it to you today. May you walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of your life. And that's all I want to say. And again, many, many congratulations to you all. Well, that is the end of this graduation ceremony, and I hope as many of you as possible can get to the reception at Craig Lockett campus. And meanwhile, would you please stand now for the academic procession?